So Baruch Hashem. And let us hope that everything we learn today will be irrelevant by the time Tisha B'Av comes. And we should be zoichel divrei Hanavi, tzoyim ha-ravi v'tzoyim ha-chamishi, tzoyim ha-shvi v'tzoyim ha-asiri, yiyu le-beis Yehudo, v'sosoin u-le-simcho u-le-moyadim toivim. So the topic we will be discussing today is Tisha B'Av Shechal, v'yechad b'Shabbos, Erev Tisha B'Av Shechal b'Shabbos. That is a relevant sugya that we will be dealing with next week, Shabbos Kodesh, Abo Oleinu L'Toivo. So the source of the sugya is an Erev in Mem Aleph Amud Aleph, Tov Kuf Nun Daled Sif Yid in Shulchan Aruch. Is there a Seuda Mafsekes when Erev Tisha B'Av is Chal B'Shabbos? And the answer is no. Mala Al Shulchanoi K'Seuda Shloime B'Shado. You could have a feast, no limits, no limitations. Shabbos is Shabbos, and Shabbos is not Erev Tisha B'Av, and therefore, Mala al Shulchanoi Kesudas Shloime B'Shado. Is it true that there are no limitations? Not necessarily. Mishnah Berurah, Sif Kot Nechov Gimel, brings the great machlokes between two giants, the Magen Avraham and the Bechor Shor. The Bechor Shor is the Tzvuas Shor, one of the greatest poskim going back 300 years. The Magen Avraham says, yes, you can eat whatever you wish, you can eat as much as you wish, but one should not bring together chaverim and family. He should eat v'davoin leiv. After all, it's Erev Tisha B'Av. So the Mishnah Berurah in Sif Kotten Chav Gimel. Do we have it on our screen? I see the Shulchan Aruch. Yes. So. After Kosova Machaba, Suda Shloima, Makol Mokam, Yoshev Vedava Nefesh, Shaloi Yinag Besimcho, Barachan, Loi Yeshev Besaudas Chavedim. Don't bring together your friends. And the Bechor Shor, quoted in the Mishnah Berurah, maintains Imrogal Bechol Shabbos, Lisoit Saudem Chavedov, Yodov, Omanea Beshabbosu, that would be defined as Averes Befar Hesia. So the Mishnah Berurah just says, with your family, you definitely sit together. And you could say, Zimun by Berchas HaMozon. So the Mishnah Berurah doesn't, is it Machria? He doesn't decide between the Magen Avraham and the Bechor Shor. But obviously, most Achronim maintain, if it's customary in your home, people come, they should come to Shabbos as well. Otherwise, it would be defined as Aveles de Farhesia. The Bechor Shor says, you know, and so that is the opinion of the Bechor Shor. According to Magen Avraham, you need to eat alone. And most Achronim maintain the opinion of the Bechor Shor. Otherwise, it would be Aveles de Farhesia. And the Igros Moshe wonders, Chelik Dalet, Semen Kuf Yud Veis, the Moshe wonders, and he says, the Bechor Shor is mashma only if that's your minig every Shabbos. And the Igros Moshe argues, even if it's not your minig every Shabbos, Suda Shloime B'Shato. So if you don't have a feast every Shabbos, would we say you can't have one Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av? Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av, the Shulchan Aruch, and it's based on the Gemara in Erev Mem Aleph, no limitations. So why would there be a difference regarding inviting guests? So the Moshe says, you can invite guests even though it's not customary and you don't do it every Shabbos. But I think the Bechor Shor is right because Suda Shabbos is a chiyuv. Shuva Shabbos is a mitzvah medivei kabbalah. Suda Shabbos is all about the korosa l'Shabbos oineg. And therefore, that would override the avelis of Erev Tisha B'Av. The avelis of Erev Tisha B'Av is not real DNA avelis. However, inviting guests to your Suda Shabbos, that's not part of Oinik Shabbos, and neither is it part of Koi Shabbos. So the argument of the Bechor Shor is just, if you won't invite them this Shabbos, that would be Avelis Tefahesia. But if you don't have, yes, other Shabbosim, why would you have guests Dafke Erev Tisha B'Av? And the comparison of Moshe's argument, well, the din of Suda Shloime B'Shata is not dependent whether you have it every Shabbos or not. Why would this din, yes, be dependent whether you have it every Shabbos or not? And I think there's a huge difference between the two, because Suda Shabbos is Suda Shabbos, and that's the mitzvah Moinik Shabbos, and therefore doesn't matter at all whether you had it last Shabbos or two Shabbos ago, whether you had guests or not, whether you had a big Suda or not. This is Oinik Shabbos, which overrides Avedas on Erev Tisha B'Av, Masha Enkein Lagabe Orchem. And therefore, the Mishnah Brura does brings two opinions. He doesn't bring the Egnis Moshe, opinion number three. Well, you understand that that's not really a big order, but it is a pshitis to the Achroinim that the heter of inviting guests is only if that is customary in your home. Doesn't depend necessarily whether you had guests the Shabbos before, but if it's your minig and it's common that you host guests for Suda Shabbos, you could do the same Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon. Regarding Talmud Torah, when Tisha B'Av falls Erev Shabbos, so Suda Shlaima B'Shata, how about learning Torah? So the Ramasim Etav Kuf Nun Gimel Siv Bey says Erev Tisha B'Av falls in Shabbos is just like any other Erev Tisha B'Av. Ulafichach ein oimrim pirkei avos. So we don't say pirkei avos Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av. So pirkei avos was a minig, a very common minig, many many years in the summer weeks between Pesach and Rosh Hashanah. Every Shabbos afternoon, people got together and learned pirkei avos. So when I came to the Mot 25 years ago, and the people in my shul were contemplating, what should I teach Shabbos afternoon? Some wanted pirkei avos, the others wanted halacha de geshir, halacha Shabbos. So I decided we're going to teach halacha, and I was very happy with that decision. So for the past 25 years, hundreds of people come to my shul Shabbos afternoon, and we learn sugyas and halacha. We went through Hilchot Shabbos many times. Right now, we're in the middle of a series of Shiurim and Choshe Mishpat, relevant questions of Choshe Mishpat. But today in Eretz Yisrael, very few shuls have Pirkei Avos in summer afternoon. And, well, I chose Halacha over Pirkei Avos, and I do not regret that decision. But the Ramo deals with Pirkei Avos. The Ramo says, when Shabbos falls, Erev Tisha B'Av, we do not say the Shiur of Pirkei Avos. I do not say a Shiur. Next week, Shabbos afternoon, I will not be saying this year. I could prefer to give a shiur in Hilchos Tisha B'Av, but as you know by now, when I give a shiur even in Hilchos Tisha B'Av, it's a happy shiur. That's the way. I don't know how to give an unhappy shiur. So, but Tisha B'Av, I do teach Kamsu Bar Kamsa. Every year in my shul, a big crowd comes after the kinnis in the morning, and we go through the sugya of Kamsu Bar Kamsa, and that is a very special atmosphere. But teaching halacha would always be Shashua Shol Torah and Chedus of the Shmaitze. And I don't think it's available to Feresi, because even if I would give a shiur, it can be in the normal time, because we daven earlier, people need to go home and have the suda. So the fact that I'm not koveya a special shiur in an earlier hour definitely would not be defined as Avedas Tefes, yeah. And therefore, next Shabbos in the afternoon, I don't give a shiur. But regarding Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av Talmud Torah, there are four different opinions. Not really four different opinions, but let's start from Aleph Beis. The Pesach of the Ramo is challenged by many great Achroinim. Primarily the Maharshal, who was Ben Doiroi, Ben Giloy, a contemporary of the Raman. The Rashal disagrees. Following in the footsteps of the Rashal, the Mama Mordechai, one of the most important Achroinim in Shulchan Aruch Arachayim, and the Gro, the Gon. And the Mashal says, so the Shloime B'Shata, no Tisha B'Av. And regarding Talmud Torah, yes Tisha B'Av. So you could eat whatever you want. You could drink wine. You could eat. You could eat anything. Suda Shloime Vishata. Ben es kumtzer lernen. That is when you're a member of Elis and Tisha B'Av. If you could eat and drink, you might as well learn as well. Argues the Mashal. So the Mashal, the Mama Mordechai, the girl, disagree with the Ramo, and they say Shabbos is Shabbos. Shabbos there's no Avelis, and just as there's no Avelis, you could invite guests. You could eat a suda. You could have the greatest feast and learn Torah as well. But the Ramah has his opinion, and Bnei Ashkenaz, always following the footsteps of the Ramah, and all the other Achronim following in the footsteps of the Ramah agree that Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av, then one should abstain from learning. Actually, the sources I quoted, the Taz, the Gra, the Mama Mordechai, their opinion is, even in the middle of a week, you could learn Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon. And they reject the entire halacha of Issa Talmud Torah Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon. Regarding Erev Tisha B'Av Shechal B'Shavis, that is the Turei Zov, Siv Kotem Beis, Maram Meloblin, Chuvas Maram Meloblin, Simen Tzadik Aleph. They are the ones that argue Shabbos Erev Tisha B'Av, if you could eat, you could also learn Torah. So the sources I quoted just a few moments ago mistakenly, those are the Marshal, the Gro, the Mama Mordechai. They bechlal maintain you could learn Tisha B'Av in the afternoon. There is no issue of learning Torah Tisha B'Av in the afternoon. So the Turei Zov is the one that argues that if you could eat, you might as well learn Torah. And that is the opinion of Maram Melhublin as well. The Ramo in the Arka Moshe quotes the Maharil, and the Middle writes, Din Erev Tisha B'Av Shechal Liyos B'Shabes is the same halacha as Erev Tisha B'Av Shechal Liyos B'Choyol, and Mechatzois V'Yelech, in the afternoon, you do not learn Torah. Theoretically, you could learn Dvorim Haroim. But Dvorim Haroim and Shabbos, once again, might be Aveda Sefer Hesia. And Shabbos is supposed to be a day of Simcha, and not a day of sorrow and of mourning. So, in Minchas Osher, Moed, and Chelek Aleph, I think, I discuss whether there is a mitzvah of Simcha in Shabbos, because all we find in the Torah is Oinig Shabbos and Simchas Yom Tov. Simchas Yom Tov is a mitzvah d'oraisa, v'samachta b'chagecha. Oinig Shabbos and Kvoit Shabbos are medivrei kabbalah, v'koros el Shabbos Oinig v'chibadatoi. But I did bring various different sources from the Shoinim that Shabbos is also a day of Simcha. There is something unreasonable about Yom Tov having a mitzvah of Simcha d'oraisa and Shabbos having nothing. Because Kvoit Shabbos and Oinig Shabbos are only midrabbanan. Kedusha Shabbos is greater than Kedusha Yom Tov. A Maloch and Yom Tov is Alav. A Maloch and Shabbos is Koros and Mises Beisdin. So regarding Simcha and the atmosphere of Shabbos, is Yom Tov far greater than Shabbos? Because Yom Tov, we have a mitzvah d'oraisa of Simchas Yom Tov. Shabbos Menatera, we have nothing besides Issa Malocha and Shvisa. So there are Rishonim that maintain if there's a mitzvah of Simchas and Yom Tov, then it definitely would refer to Shabbos as well. What we do have in Shabbos is Mekroi Kodesh. What is the definition of Mekroi Kodesh? So in Sefri, we learn B'machal, B'mishta. So even though Oinig Shabbos is Medivra Kabbalah, but Mekroi Kodesh does mean something. But that is a separate discussion, which is not very relevant to our shiur today. But let's just get back to the different opinions regarding Erev Tisha B'Av Talmud Torah. So some Gedolim, Bnei Doirei Shel Ramah, disagree with the entire issue of learning Torah, Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon. Most Poskim maintain there is an issa to learn Torah Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon, but the question is only regarding Erev Tisha B'Av Shechali is B'Shabbos. So the Ramah, based on the Maril, says, Din Shabbos K'din Choyol. And just like we don't learn Torah Erev Tisha B'Av in any other day, we don't learn Torah Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon, Shabbos as well. And that is why the Maril and the Ramah says, we don't say the Shia of Pirkei Avos. On the other hand, Shuvas Maram Melublin, Turei Zov, they say, if you could eat Kesuda Shloime Bishato, you could learn Torah as well. Tisha B'Av Nidcha is another sugya. So Tisha B'Av Nidcha is when Tisha B'Av falls on Shabbos, and we actually observe Tisha B'Av B'Kol Proteo V'Digdokeo on Sunday. So the Magen Avraham argues, Tisha B'Av Shechali is B'Shabbos V'Nidcha Le Yom Rishon, there's an Issur of Talmud Torah all day from Knesset Shabbos, the Yetzias Shabbos. Because regarding Tisha B'Av Nidcha, Avedis B'Tzinah is Noeg. But that is a separate discussion which is not relevant this year. So we'll leave it next time. Be'ez Hashem, we'll have Tisha B'Av Shechali Shabbos. I didn't check when that will be. Don't take this as an obligation to keep up the Archikala Shia till Tishabab Shechalis Mishamis. I hope we will, but don't take this as a neder, b'li neder. So those are the opinions regarding Talmud Torah and Tishabab Shechalis Be'erev Shabbos. And as I said, my minig is, I don't give the Shia in my shul. I adhere to the Ramah. The Tisha B'Av Shechalis B'Av Shabbos, we don't give a shiur, the Rabbim. Chassam Sofer, Anna's great son, Diksav Sofer, following in his footsteps, they have a new interpretation, a new explanation. What is the Issa to learn Torah? Tisha B'Av Shechal Liyois. Erev Tisha B'Av Shechal Liyois B'Shabbos. Shuvas Chasam Sofer, Orachaim Simen Kuf Nun Vav. So Chasam Sofer argues, it's not about Avelis. There are no Dine Avelis Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon, more than 9 days. The reason we don't learn Torah, Erev Tisha B'Av, Mechatzos is, if you learn Torah properly, when you close the Gemara, it's not over. I want a person to learn Torah. By the nature of Torah, you digest even after you finish learning, and you think in Torah, and you're engaged in Talmud Torah. And therefore, the chashash is, if you're going to learn Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon, then Simchas HaTorah will fill your heart a few hours later, and you're going to be engaged in Talmud Torah Tisha B'Av, and that is why the halacha is Erev Tisha B'Av Liachach Hatzais, you do not learn. And the Ksav Sofer, as usual, follows in the footsteps of his great father, Juvis Ksav Sofer, Or HaChaim Simen, Kuf Aleph. So we have the Ksav Sofer on our screen, and the Ksav Sofer deals Tisha B'Av Shechalias B'Shabbos V'Nidcha. And the Tisha B'Av and the Chassam Sofer brings the Magen Avraham. The Magen Avraham says, you can't learn all day. And the Chassam Sofer offers his explanation. Why don't we learn Erev Tisha B'Av in the afternoon? And the Chassam Sofer writes, the Chashash is, you're going to be Sameach B'Simchas HaTorah hours after you learn. And according to his interpretation, he disagrees with the Magen Avraham and he says, Tisha B'Av Shechalias B'Shabbos, it is only in the afternoon that we need to abstain from Talmud Torah. What is the Issa learning Torah on Tisha B'Av? So most of the Rishonim and Achroidim maintain, based on the Gemara Daf Lamed and Aleph and Tanis, I think last week we discussed the Braisa, Kol HaMitzvos HaNoyegos B'Av or Noyegos B'Tisha B'Av. Also, Bachila Vishia Varachitza Vesich Anilis Santas Mishmita and Mevatla Metal Metoira. Kudi Hashem Yishorim Mesam Chalev. And that is also the Loshon of the Shulchan Aruch. And Tov Kuf Nun Dalet Sif Aleph. You can't learn Torah on Tisha B'Av because Tisha B'Av is supposed to be a day of mourning and of sorrow and of sadness. And Torah will make you happy. Kudi Hashem Yishorim Mesam Chalev. The Maharsho has a different approach. And the Maharsho Tanis the Flamet Omed Aleph, and the source of the Sigur, the Mashal says, the Issa Talmud Torah is Masiach Das Min HaAvelis. You are supposed to be engaged in mourning, actively engaged. Avelis and Tisha B'Av is not only about Sheva'al Taisa. It's not only about not wearing shoes and not doing this and not doing that. It is about feeling the tragedy of Churban Beis Hamikdash. And that is why when you learn Torah, it's not about Simcha of Talmud Torah, it is about Yasiach Das Min Huavelis. And when the Gemara says, Kudi Hashem Yishorim Mesam Chalev, it is only Mevatlin Tinoikis Shel Beis Rabon. So the approach of the Mashal is, little children are not Chayev Bavelis. So little children don't have the reasoning of Shemi Yasiach Das Menu Avelis. There is even no Chiyuv of Chinuch to Avelis. So the Mashal says, it is only regarding children that the Gemara explains, Kudi Hashem Yishorim Misam Chalev, But the Iker Tam of Issa Talmud Torah is Shemi Asiyach Das Min Avelis. And that is why everything that is Nageya to Avelis or to the Chorim, you are entitled to learn on Tisha B'Av. So if it would be Simcha, when you learn Hilchos Tisha B'Av, it should be Misameach, just as anything else you learn. But if you're learning Hilchos Tisha B'Av, there is no Hesach Das Min Avelis, and that is the approach of the Mashal. But the Meshur Zayochid and all the others say that the Sefer Meshum Pekud Yashem Yishom Esam Chalev goes on the entire halacha, not only Mevatlin Tinoike Shel Beis Abayim. To the contrary, the Taz asks a very relevant question. So Mevatlin Tinoike Shel Beis Rabon Meshum Shepekud Yashem Yishom Esam Chalev. So aren't we all familiar with the Pusuk Kitina Kabareach Mebeis HaSefer? So when I meet little kids, as I did this morning here in Luxor, I usually ask little children, what do you want to be when you're going to be big? I had some surprising answers throughout the years. One told me he wants to be a hockey player, football. I had some surprising answers. The most original answer I had from my Einikel, he was 10 years old at the time, and I asked him, Yuda, ma ata rotze liot kishetia gadol? And he looks me in the eye and he says, ani gadol. I am big. What type of a shaila is that? Yeah. I never had that answer in America again, yeah. So they all say, most of them, 95% tzaddik, talmud chacham, begod lador. So my Rebbe, the Kloisim Ogar Rebbe, used to tell the story, Zechat Tzadik V'Kodesh Rocha, that the Divra Chaim once asked the boy, do you like to learn? And he said, no. And the Divra Chaim said, wow, you're an Ish Emes. You're an Ish Emes. So kids would always prefer playing to learning. So why is it Mavatlun Talmud Torah? Mishum Tanoyti Shavisabim. So the Taz says, it's not about the kids, it's about the Malamdim. Oh, that was maybe 300 years ago. If we would make a survey in Chedorim today, ask the Malamdim, would you prefer a day off, or do you really enjoy teaching the kids? I think they also, most of them would say, I would prefer spending time at home or learning, but not teaching children. So the Aruch HaShulchan also deals with this question. But kids don't really learn, like to learn that much, and they don't. So I think the approach, the Aruch HaShulchan says, in a very fundamental way, Torah misamachas liboy shel adam. Not always is it obvious, not always is it evident, not always do you really feel it, but it is the way it is, and it is the way it should be. Pekudei Hashem Yishor HaMasam Chalei. And there are always exceptions, different times, different people, different individuals. But in a fundamental way, Torah is Simcha, and Simcha is Torah. And all the Sifra Misa deals so much with Simcha HaTorah. And we as Marbitz HaTorah make such an effort to be Misameach Levavos B'Divrei Torah. A thousand times I quoted Rabbeinu Yoina, Perek Beis, Mishnah Yudalad, Masechet Tavis. Rabbeinu Yoina says, Kishatu Misyageya Betoyre Tishtash Ayabo. Shashua Shotoyre, Simcha Satoyre is the key. It's the key to growing in Toyre. It's the key to Godless Betoyre. So maybe the kids do like, don't like the Malam, they might yes, might no, but in a fundamental way, Toyre is and should be Misameach L'Sholodom. And that is why Chazal answered, Talmud Toyre B'Tisha. However, there's a Yerushalmi. The Yerushalmi in Masechet Chagiga, Perek Gimel, Mishnah Hay, not Chagiga, Moed Kotten, naturally, all the dinam of Avelis are in Moed Kotten. And the Yerushalmi says, Ovel Halohut Achrei Divrei Torah is allowed to learn Vime Avelus. So this is a story I told many times. I remember once I was in the room of my great Rebbe, the Klois Magarebi, and a person walked in. People are coming in and out, and I happened to be there. And a person gave the Rebbe a gift, a biography of the Tzofen Spaneach, of the Rugged Shover. And the Rugged Shover, as you all know, was a phenomenal Godel, won you know, one of a kind. There never was an assembly line for Rabbi Chavez. And in that book, it was written that he was sitting Shiva and he learned all the time. And that was quite a sight. So the Kloisimbe Rebbe took a pen and he struck it out. Not once, but like this. Sometimes he was very, I don't want to use the word theatrical, but it was, you know, it was a symbolic act. Struck it out. At that moment, I didn't want to say anything because it would be a chutzpah. But a few days later, you know, I asked him, well, a few days ago, person brought a seif on the tzavos panech, and you took a pen, you struck it out. But the Yerushalmi says that over alot achrei divrei Torah could learn Torah. Do we know anyone that was more lohut achrei divrei Torah than the tzavos panech? The Rabbi Chava wasn't Messiah Das, you know, needed Torah, you know. He smiled, he didn't respond. So over alot achrei divrei Torah. So this actually comes with a story. The Tzofet Smeich was sitting Shiva, and Reb Naftuli Vyershever came to be Menachem Ovo. Reb Naftuli Vyershever was a very famous and renowned Godel in Poland. His name was Reb Chaim Yankov Naftuli Zilberberg, and he was Rav in a town in Poland, which was Vyershev. He was a great Godel. He was a Gera Chosid, a Chosid of the Sfasemis. He learned Musar in the Beis Medish of Rabbi Sol Salanter, and he was a Talmud of the Beis Alevi. That is quite a coalition. When you have three Rabbeim, you have the Lomdus of the Beis Alevi, the Chassidus of the Sosemis, and the Musar of Rabbi Sol Salanter, you can't go wrong. So, and he was a real great God. The story I most tell, you know, we're talking about Talmud Torah now, so excuse me for not being so focused only on Lomdus and on Halacha, but these stories are very important. And it's important that we all hear great stories. I am not a storyteller. And after a year and a half listening to my shulim, you know that I tell very, very few stories. I say very, very few stories. And the stories I do tell, I am very makbid, they should be emes. That is the reason I don't tell many stories. So, Dr. Emanuel Kallebach, who was a Rav in Germany, writes in a letter to his family. It was the beginning of the Aguda, which brought so many Gedolim together from different cultures, from different countries, and they got to know each other. So, Rabbi Dr. Emanuel Kallebach, I think was his name, writes a letter. And he writes, I got to know one of the Gedolim in Poland, Reb Naftuli Vyershever. And he needed an operation. I accompanied him to the hospital and they told him we can't do this because we need to do general anesthesia. And he was 80 years old. And they said it would be a great danger to his life. So they can't perform the surgery. And he begged them and he said he was willing to sign they should do the surgery without anesthesia. And the doctor said, it's impossible, it was never done. But he implored and he begged them and they agreed. And I accompanied him a week later when he came to do the operation. So Dr. Kallebach writes, they rolled him into the operating theater and he started saying Gemara by heart. The operation took 2 hours. And he went through Yud Ches Dafim Balpe, Bekasher Es Gabru Yisurov, Hirim Bekoiloi. I was in the other room and I could hear when he was learning out loud. And when the operation was over, I went in to see him and ask how he's feeling. V'omer li chidush bedivrei harashbo. That's what he writes. I will never forgive him for not sharing with us what was that chiddush and which raspo. I need to know that. Person in surgery without anesthesia, in intense pain. I only went through 18 blat gemora. Said a chiddush b'divrei raspo. Well, I don't blame him because probably his wife and daughters back in Germany wouldn't appreciate the Chiddush B'Divrei HaRashba, but we lost out. We lost out. That's a historical loss. What was that Chiddush that was Mechadash and Rashba? So that was the Maftole V'Yerushofer. And he was the one that visited the Tzofnus Panech, B'Yamei Avloi, and the Tzofnus was learning. And he asked him, Avarosu B'Talmud Torah. And what the Tzofnus Smech, the Rosh Hashanah, said, Usa, b'madaf nishtarm, he said, you don't need to die for Avelis. You know, that was his sharpish prach. He said, it's also, but you don't need to die for Avelis. You don't need to die for Avelis. And to me, it brings to mind the lesson of the Rambam, Perek Zayin Hilchos Ritzeach, and the Rambam quotes the Gemara Makas Dafyud. Talmud shegala le'iyem miklot maglin rabu yimoy. And why is that? Because the Pasuk says, v'nasa lachas orem eilev v'chai, avid leicha yusu. You need to give him life. And the lesson of the Rambam is, v'chayei balei hachochmo umivaksheho, leloi talmud kemise chashuvim. Chayei balei hachochmo umivaksheho, leloi talmud kemise chashuvim. So the Tzofnus Smenech said, what do you expect me to die in Shivus Yemei Avelis? Enough one death. You don't want another one, Medaf Nishtarben. So he said, that's Ovel Halohut Achrei Divrei. So on one hand, there's a Shulchan Aruch, and there is Chazal, and an Ovel is also B'Talmud Torah. But I ain't any Machmi Yoyser Medai, you know. In any machmi yoisim edai, I can't say I'm an oval alot achrei divrei Torah, but something comes into my mind, I make a note because I don't want to forget. But definitely, so Rabbi Shlomo Kluger writes also lekvoya atzmo le divrei Torah. But if divrei Torah comes into your mind, then you're allowed to think. Twice a shas, kedushan lamed gimel and zvochem kufalof, we find amiroam and tenoam that were oisig b'toyre b'beis hakisei. And it's Rav quoting Reb Shimon ben Elozo, or Reb Elozo ben Reb Shimon, maybe I'm confusing the two. The Torah toyre b'beis hakisei, and the Gemara asks, also b'divre toyre b'makoy misatanofim, and the Gemara says, la'on soy shani, he was an oinus, what could he do? Rashi writes in Zvachim, but that's a Chiddush. He was sitting inside, his Talmidim were outside, and they heard him teaching. It's easier for us to understand you're an oinus to think of Torah, an oinus to teach Torah, to verbalize and to vocalize Torah. That's far a greater Chiddush. But that's what the Gemara says. So there is a matzav that people are so dovek b'Torah that Yefshah. Probably the heter would be oinus. Oinus sechmona patre. You know, it's just the way it is. Oinus sechmona patre. So, Tisha B'Av is also a Talmud Torah. As we quoted, in two different areas, do we find that there are exceptions. Yushalmi, Masechet Meit Kotn and Dinei Avelis, twice in Bavli, V'makoy Mesamet Tunofim. Zeveze, we find a heter of oinus. So this coming Shabbos afternoon, normal Shabbos day, you eat whatever you wish, you drink whatever you wish. You definitely could have your family coming over. And if you are rogel to have guests, you could have guests as well. I think most families wouldn't go to others Shabbos afternoon, because after all, you need to finish eating Meboid Yom before the Shkia and prepare for Tisha B'Av. So, these are the halachos. Regarding Talmud Torah, if you're an oinus, lo atachad divrei Torah, well, I wouldn't recommend being Meikel Tisha B'Av, but Erev Tisha B'Av, Shabbos afternoon, yesh lehem al mashi yismoichu, but I don't think it's appropriate to be kaveya she'urim b'rabi. Rabim negedas arama is not the right thing to do, unless you're learning Hilchos Tisha B'Av. Then you could be kaveya berabim as well. I don't think we should learn Eicha, Devora Maroim, because that's not the spirit of Shabbos. Shabbos should be a matzav of simcha, but you definitely could learn Berabim before learning Hilchos Tisha B'Av, which you could even learn on Tisha B'Av as well. So that definitely would be permissible. So once again, it's a simcha to be with you. And usually when we finish the shiur, I just give a bracha. So what should I wish you today? I wish you all a happy listening at Tisha B'Av. Because everything is possible. And we very much hope every day. L'kiyum divrei hanavi, tzoyim ha-ravi v'tzoyim ha-chamishi, tzoyim ha-shvi v'tzoyim ha-asiri, yiyu le-beis Yehuda, le-sosoin u-le-simcho u-le-moya dim-toyim. And that's a posek in Zechariah Novi. And the end of the posek is three words, v'hu emes v'asholoim ha-heivu. And the question is, what does the reisha of the posek have to do with the seifa? So the reisha is an expression of hope, a bracha, a promise. These tragic days of mourning will ultimately be transformed to days of joy, and we will rejoice. So the Navi says, you'll ask me, when will it be? And he says, I can't tell you when, but I could tell you how. How will it be? The base of Migdash Arishon was Chorev, twice in Shas, Chazal say, Bavoyim Bitul Torah. Almu Ovda Horetz al Ozva Mestirosi, Shalei Bohu B'Torah Techilo. And the Ran explains that Torah wasn't precious in their eyes. Shalei Bohu B'Torah Techilo. I once had a vort, and I think it's a gewaltig vort. So what is the hadgosha? Why do Chazal stress le'bochu b'toyre t'chilo? They didn't say berchas ha'toyre. What is that dosha t'chilo? There was a ruah, some other Rishonim ask, there are only two brochas that are min ha'toyre, berchas ha'mazon and berchas ha'toyre. We would expect them to have the same basic rules, but no. Berchas ha'toyre we say before learning, berchas ha'mazon you say after eating. Why is that? If I would have my way, my answer would be a very pushy one. You never finish learning. You're supposed to learn atzitachta fenashina. So when are you going to say berchas ha'toyre? When after you're learning, that means in the middle of your sleep, you're going to say berchas ha'toyre. For me to come and learn till they fall asleep. So how can you say berchas ha'toyre after you finish learning? You never finish learning. But some Rishonim say, Berachas HaTorah is before learning, Berachas HaMazon is after eating. Because when a person eats, we don't expect him to be so happy when he sits down at the table. But when you come to learn Torah, you should be overwhelmed with joy just walking into the Beis HaMedrash. And that is the reason we say Berachas HaTorah before learning. So let me share a story with you, a family story. There's a famous story about Rabbi Yonis and Ibishis, which I told many, many times. It transpired that one of the Balabatim sitting very close to the Rav, to Rabbi Yonis and Ibishis, seemed to realize that in Berachas HaShachar he's not saying the Brocha Shalai Yusani Goy. He was shocked. So a day later, he inched even closer to Rabbi Yonison and it was clear to him, he skips the Brocha Shalai Yusani Goy and he didn't know what to make of it. So he went to the Beis Din and he told him, this is what I heard. And it's up to you if you think something should be done. The Beis Din sent a special shliach. He skips the Brocha Shalai Yusani Goy. I don't know whether that was in the midst of the controversy with Rabbi Yankov Vendin with the entire story, I don't know. But they fasted because they're going to confront the Gadol HaDor. And they went into the Bionis and he said, this is what we know. This is what we realized. And could the Rav please explain why doesn't he say Shalai Yusani Goy? So he said, I get up in the morning and I wash my hands And I'm so overwhelmed with thankfulness to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to a gratitude. That's a bin ayin. I can't wait till I get to shul. I say, Maida Ani, and I say the Baruch Hashem Hilsani Goy. Told the story by Shia. A few days later, my daughter calls me that my little granddaughter, 7 years old, every day started saying, Shalom Hilsani Goy after Natilas Adayim in the morning. Oh, I was so moved. Brought tears to my eyes. Might have told Aleah, so, Berachas HaTorah, we can't wait till after we finish learning. Berachas HaTorah, we say when we come into the Beis Medrash. Berachas HaTorah, we say when we get up in the morning. And maybe that is the emphasis. Maybe they said Berachas HaTorah. They said it when they finished learning. To them, it was like Berachas HaMazon. You gotta eat. You gotta learn Torah. Sometimes you enjoy your food, sometimes you enjoy your learning. And that is what brought the Chorban. What destroyed by a Sheni? Yomed Avtes, Sinas Chinam. So the Novi says, I promise you these days will be days of joy. When? Bo Emes Vasholon Ahiv. Ein Emes Elo Toiro. Chosom Hashem HaKadosh Baruch Hu Emes. And that is the Toiro. When you will love Torah and you will rectify what brought about the Churban of Bayis Rishon, and you will love each other, and you will live in peace and in harmony instead of sinas chinam, and you'll fix what broke the Bayis Sheni, it is then and only then that you will be zaycha. Tzayim haRavi v'tzayim haChamishi, tzayim haShvi'i v'tzayim haAsiri, yiyu leBeis Yehuda. Sasain ula simcha ula mayadim tayyim. Bemheiru v'yameinu amen. So let us all have a list to get this above.